guess. I didn't expect to make my album, but that
was different. Is it sort of reminiscent of what's going on here, or is it clearly different sound?
For me, there's all kinds of stuff going on there. There's some punk bands, you know, a compilation, 18 bands on a compilation. For me, it was 1979, 81 in London, 1981, 82 in New York.
That's the sound that was coming out of there.
And maybe also the spirit of two of the guys in Snapline playing classic pop. Bands are interchanging members. This one called 322. Let's the band rehearse that, slide them a few things, gives them a bit of money. You know, more money than they're worth. But they're really nurturing the scene. And just one nice band. Oh my goodness, wow, great. Here comes another band. This is a girl with a little ratchet toy and a move and some other sound man. Sound man's losing his fucking mind because he's going from a punk band to, okay, she's got a ratchet. Now she's hitting this metal chair, leaning back and stuff. But she's just dealing with it, you know. And, oh, I love this.
Sounds like an exciting time.
Yeah. It's kind of re-energized me.
Because there's not really a whole lot like that going on here, is there?
No. And the gleeful experimentation. I mean, I don't mean this to sound weird, but it's almost like, oh, God bless him. You know, it's like being a Disneyland. I wouldn't enjoy going to any time. Where I take my kids, I just enjoy seeing it because it's like that. Without sounding like a patronizing
person. No, but you are vicariously sort of getting into the spirit and remembering when you felt that way.
And,
they did take Viagra to get that.
Yeah, it's fucking great. And then just working with instruments like the Indian drum or a bass. I think I'll be in that situation. And it just kind of kept me on my toes. And I was jet lagged and exhausted, so my attention was up and my battery was down. It was really good.
So for the kids there, like rock out, playing air Urdu?
But I don't think I was really careful to cut the what I wanted to do with the traditional instruments out of the headphones. Sometimes I just had to play to like a single loop. So I knew I could take it somewhere else. And the same with the cooler instruments. I didn't let them hear some of the traditional instruments. It's just like someone said to me, hey, Mark, you got a studio, we've got studio time here in Manhattan, we're laying down amazing banjo. Like, yeah, okay. So I just kept it separate, and towards the end, a few of them heard, like, I'm like, okay, put those things. But these are traditional instruments, and the DJ was scratching. If you heard it, I think you would have been like,
welcome back.